Listen, my dear little daughter. The first condition of all existence is and always remains love. But mind you, only true love, as I, as eternal love itself, taught all people and initially placed it in the heart of every person for themselves. If someone seeks to develop this true love in his heart, according to my teaching, then he walks the perfectly right way to the true rebirth of his spirit. If someone has achieved this, he has also achieved the actual true goal of his life. In order to achieve this most important goal, however, one has to be very, very careful on the path of formation of one's heart and must ask oneself with every inclination of one's heart whether such an inclination does not contain something of the bad seed of self-love besides true love. True love is dispassionate throughout. It seizes everything with the greatest power and strength and never let go what it once grasped. But in spite of this, such true love work is always an extremely gentle one, accompanied by the greatest tolerance. But the work of self-love, though in itself highly important, appears only too soon as an action that wants to destroy immediately everything that wants to step unfavorably into its selfish way. And this behavior is exactly the passion that is at home there, in self-love. Therefore, as I said, everyone must be careful in the formation of his heart, whether it is nourished with true love or sometimes with small portions of self-love. And that is exactly what you, my dear little daughter, must be very careful about if you want to experience the true birthday of your spirit as soon as possible. See, human life is well and right if one loves human beings because they are human beings and does not make distinctions, except insofar as someone is closer or further away from me, according to their spiritual standpoint. For there, a difference is just. No one can serve two masters, i.e., a good and a bad, at the same time. But somehow, for worldly reasons, preference for certain worldly dignities and values of the human being is already self-love, because in the end, the heart seeks its own exaltation, if quite secretly, but nevertheless surely. And when such an endeavor, no matter how quietly, manifests itself, there is no longer humility, but a pride hidden in such love is the mainspring of the moral movement of the heart. Therefore, if your heart takes hold of something, ask always if it does not claim your earthly sense of honor subordinated to the so-called higher world. If this finds its saturation in an enterprise of your heart, this is already a sign of self-love, which has lain down behind the thicket on the educational path of your heart like a bad bushwhacker, and with time wants to spoil all that is noble as a secret emissary of hell. Because self-love, even in its most inconspicuous forms, is nothing but an evil seed that the enemy of life sprinkles among the noble wheat so that it may wither in its sprouting or possibly even completely destroyed. Therefore, one must carefully examine the love of people and keep asking the heart, why do you love this and that, or also with things this and that? If in this the heart will answer out of humility, then the love is right and leads you to spiritual perfection. But if the heart responds out of an ancestral worldly vanity, then love is no longer love, but vain selfishness only, which may well seem to be done to love with the lamb's garment, but inside is only a raging wolf. which in the end tears apart all that is noble in the heart and strives to crush the spirit wherever possible. I give you, my dear little daughter, this small but nevertheless extremely important teaching and true rule of life as your extremely good father, like a good penny on your earthly journey of life, so that with careful use of it, you can even easily reach the real and true goal of your earthly journey of life. Once you have achieved this, only then will you see in full how infinitely good he is who gives you this little word for your physical birthday, so that you will want to reach the birthday of your spirit all the sooner. Love me above all, as I love you above all, and do not let your heart be blinded by the world, so you will have an easy and gentle way to walk. I tell you, your good father. Amen.